Hello. Let's talk about an 8-stage voltage multiplier. And this is an experimental setup. And we have also going to see the simulation of this. There are 8 stages, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 capacitors, and then diodes connected in this fashion as per the voltage multiplier circuit. We have an input of 300 volts and the output is between these two points. In order to measure the output voltage, since it's not practicable to measure the high voltage, we have made a potential divider comprising of 10 resistors, 1 mega ohm each. So whatever voltage we get here, if we multiply it by 10, that will be the output voltage. In the simulation, of course, we can see the output voltage because the simulation can show it. But as far as the meter is concerned, when we have to see in our own practical way, the meter we have to connect across one resistor only so that we can see what is the total voltage once we multiply this voltage. We have connected a load here also, and we have connected an ammeter to see how much current it is drawing. Initially, let's see that we don't have the load on. So we will switch off the load, okay, we put a switch for the load, and then we connected an CRO oscilloscope in order to see what is the ripple factor when we load a particular value. Then we have the arrangement where we had seen our setup of a 8-stage arrangement where we had seeing that as the load resistance goes on increasing or the current goes on falling or the load goes on falling as the resistance goes on increasing, and this is the value what we have seen in our table, that if I use an 100 k in an 8-stage arrangement, the output voltage will be roughly about 2.145 kilovolts and a current of about 21 milliampere, so so this is what is the arrangement that we have at the moment. Now we'll go back to our original original circuit where we have the 8-stage multiplication, and then this is what is the circuit. Now once we simulate this, there is a CRO, we will see it later, and what we see is, now if I pause it, okay, now you find this voltage is around 2392.1 without load. Now load is not connected, and at every stage you can see the voltage. This stage the voltage is around 500 volts. This stage about 1100 volt, 1196, and so on like that. And our input is 300 volts. Why I have taken input as 300 volts is because the peak voltage, we have taken into consideration the peak voltage of the supply voltage roughly. And then in that situation, we get a DC voltage of 237 volts here. If we can look at that, we get a DC voltage of 237 volts. And once we go to the load in the CRO, what we saw, I find it's a pure DC now. And once we put the load on, once we put the load on, we find that, we find that the load has fallen, and this is the ripple factor that we get. And the current is roughly around 21 milliampere as we had seen in our calculations. And the current here, what we can see, is roughly around 21 milliampere, 21.5 or so is the current that we have. So this is what is the setup that we have, and we will try to put it on the hardware, and on the hardware also we find it exactly same.
Hi, let's now try to understand little more
about the 8-stage voltage multiplier circuit. What we had seen in the last video about the functioning, we will go into the how the circuit really works. Now, for example, if this is my supply voltage, and my supply voltage is, we have taken deliberately about the 300 volt, because that will be indicating the peak voltage as compared to the RMS voltage normally that we see in our multimeters or in a voltmeter. So let's see how it works. Now, when the supply, say, if this side is positive in the one half cycle, this side is positive and this side is negative, so what happens? The positive supply would start this way, this will forward bias this diode and it go this way and then starts this charging the capacitor and comes back to the source. So it starts from the positive, goes this way, charges the capacitor, a positive, and reaches here. All this happens in the one half cycle. And in the next half cycle, what happens when the supply reverses? That means this becomes negative and this becomes a positive. So what happens? What we find, now this was already charged to the voltage of V. Supposing this is V, it has already charged to the V. And now this side is positive, this side is negative. In the other half cycle, we found that this is positive, this is negative. So what happens? Positive, negative, they get added. And between this point to this point, it becomes V plus V. So between this point to this point, it is 2V. And since this is 2V between these two points, so this positive now travels here and then this diode gets forward biased and it flows this way, and this is charged to 2V because this 2V was available here and this 2V is now coming and getting charged here and charging this capacitor to 2V because between here and here what we found, 2V was available and that 2V was charged the capacitors this to 2V. And again on the next half cycle, this becomes positive, this becomes negative. So whatever 2V was available here is now added with this voltage, that is positive, negative, and with respect to this, this point becomes 3V, because 2V plus V is 3V. So that 3V is now charged. Now this capacitor charges to 3V this way. So, and so on. It goes on to, this goes to 4kV, this goes to 4V, this goes to 5V, this goes to 6V and 7V and 8V. This is how it works. And mind it, this capacitor gets charged to the peak of the voltage and not the RMS voltage what we normally know. And then coming to the load versus the pulsating voltage, that we will also see that and what happens when we load the circuit. Now let's, for example, we now try to simulate this. And what we find is that if the load is not connected, you know, supposing the load, the load is not connected, what we find that in the zero range, this is the zero range, that I have kept the CRO in the AC range, not in the DC range. I kept the CRO in AC range to see the pulsating voltage, and let me keep this at say 1 volt scale. And since I kept it in 1 volt scale, and it is not loaded, because the loading earlier, if you look at the loading is only these series resistors of 1 mega ohm each, about 10 mega ohm. So it's a very, very negligible load, because the resistance is 10 mega ohms. Whereas if this is a 100k load, if I switch on this now, what happens? We will see that when this 100k load is switched on, what you can see is that, see, from this point, what we found, that from this point the voltage is roughly going to in every, you know, this is also in the 5 millis, the scale is in the 5 millisecond range, and if we can expand this also so that we can see in the 2 millisecond range, and with that means if each division is 2 millisecond, what we know, that means from here to here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 10 milliseconds. So for what happens, what we can now see, this capacitor charges. This capacitor charges from here to here and then discharges. And then again discharges and then again charges, and that is how the operation. Now let's go to the scale again, back again. Now if I bring it to the off, if I bring it to the ground, let us see where the ground is. Now ground is here, this place, okay. To get a reference, in this line the ground is, okay. Now if I take it to the AC range, when I take it to the AC range, what we found is, what we found is that the pulsating DC is, this is the place, this is the place where the voltage is, the ripple voltage is rising to this and then falling and then going this way and this. But as far as the DC is concerned, we can only see it when we take into 20 volt range, because the supply voltage what we have taken is about 200 volts. Now supposing I take it to in the 20 volt scale and I take it to the DC range. If I take it to the DC range, what we find, okay, now this was my zero line, this was my zero line, and so what is the voltage now? How many divisions? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Or maybe this is the range now. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, around 9. 9 means 20 into 9 is about 180 volts. That is what when we load this. When we do not load it, like for example, when I do not load this now, when I do not load this, I find the voltage is nearly in this range. How many divisions? If this was the zero here, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, a point something, so nearly about 10. So 20 to 10 is about 200 volts that I'll be getting if I load this to this, and it is showing 237 volts as far as the meter is concerned. So when it is not loaded, we find that the voltage is pure DC, and but when it is not loaded, the voltage is pure DC. When it is loaded, we find there is a slight pulsating DC, and the average DC falls, and there is a pulsating DC also above the certain voltage. In any case, from here to here is DC, but the DC has pulsating range. To see the exact pulsating range, so we can take it to the AC scale, and we find that in the AC scale we are able to read. Now supposing I take it to the 1 volt scale, I find this will be the pulsating voltage over the voltage that we had seen. Now how it happens, let's see how it happens. That is very common as far as the any situation is concerned.